Thank you. Thank you, Rajeshwari. And thanks to Captain Checker, who connected me via Pro Bono Consulting. And I, on behalf of my institution, IMS, feel privileged to speak among the elite gathering. For whatever information I'll be sharing will be of quite a use, because the moment I saw that there'll be a 10 minutes interaction, so I thought instead of going with the PPT, let me discuss it, or tell first of all what I have with myself. And after reading a lot of content available through the McKinsey report and various other authentic reports, that what have been the latest development where IT intervention has taken place in supply chain. We all know that it's a complete different world since this pandemic situation came in. And if I talk with specification in India, since January was the time when this thing started, and in March, we have all observed a lockdown situation, and that was such a panic situation where the maximum outrage, if we could see, was through the supply chain. I hope you all agree that we have seen families collecting their daily household eating items, storing them for days and days. And that led to scarcity in the market, because government as though was appealing that there'll be no shortage and do not try to hoard. But that gives you an idea that how complex the supply chain situation could have been if you see to the background of this operational field, that when people start storing in excess, there where the role of emergence of supply chain comes into picture. And with passage of time, when this lockdown was happening and people were, as a consumer, were struggling hard to keep their rhythm slow, you know, understand the anxieties which they were going through, what will happen next. Slowly and gradually, from May onwards, we found that things, as the cases were rising, you know, but there was a massive development via IT and supply chain. So what kind of a development have we seen? I felt that whatever were the areas of, you know, questions in the mind of consumers, they were starting getting answered. The first question was food supplies. The second question was medical supplies. Me being a consumer, I was thinking that maybe, you know, my daily meals which I need, my whether they are your basic groceries or your pulses, come what may, which comes from the agriculture lands, or they are in the retail sector, how would it reach when there is a lockdown? But when from June onwards, when the lockdown situation were being relaxed, we could find, and in fact, locally, things started getting arranged in a much better way. So there we found that if I take an example of company like Amul, if we take a company like Asian, so they came out with the wonderful ideas. In fact, because so-called the production, they all had to lock down. So how would their survival model, their employees, how would you know, the company survive? So they have to come out with an alternative model, that how should the production, once this lockdown closes, will work. So there came the role of IT, that with the help of IT, how can we make this contact part into a contactless part, in a touch condition to a touchless condition. That means even, and I would say it didn't happen so much into the manufacturing of daily needs item. The hospitality sectors, whether it is tourism, everywhere the supply chain was directly impacted. Hotels were not opening, they were not calling their employees. So now this led to a situation that if I do not go physically to that place, then what should come in between? So there came few things which were being developed all across the world and which started solving problem. So we moved on to a situation named as additive manufacturing. Now, additive manufacturing in itself, first tool which they talked about is 3D printing. When we were supposed to make the companies who were involved in making aircrafts, they started making models of ventilators, for that matter, for through this 3D printing, and that helped a lot in designing the machine, the ventilator machines. So whether they were like multiple people who can be helped out with this multi-connecting ventilators, or the simulation devices that were being created without the physical intervention. So that was one of the most, you can say, unique place where the IT intervened, and with the help of this additive manufacturing through 3D printing, the designs and layouts were being created without anybody moving from their location, and they were being shared where they were to be manufactured and finally were reaching to the end consumer. Second, if I talk about the situation, has been usage of drones. We all have, again, like I said, from moving from contact to contactless. So people wanted everything at their home. You know, the deliveries should be at home so that they come minimum in contact with people in the market and so on in any workplace. So people had a high need of things being delivered at their home. So companies found that in place of customer coming to them, now what can be a remedial method? So there they started using drone. Like if I talk about whether it is Walmart, whether it is Amazon, maybe we find that this application with respect to India is still very less, but companies are doing it. But across the world, if we see, then it has become quite prevalent. So with the help of drones, whether it was your food supplies, whether it was your medical supplies, and that too, it was not dependent on now the GPS locator, because we have seen that drones were failing when they were only dependent on the GPS locator. In fact, they were being now programmed through AI for a better location understanding, and they have been, their algorithms were being designed in a way that it reaches to the right location and they'll drop it there, and later on and they'll go back to the source place, but the customer can come later to pick them up and they can do the rest of the job. So second place where supply chain has seen this drastic change was, instead of physically things being delivered via humans, so machine took a place. Not only this, there have been companies which have used AI robots for this same physical delivery system. Other than the drones itself, there have been robotic involvement in solving these complex situations. So this has actually, you know, if I say from the supply chain point, so there has been disruption. In this new normal, none of the practices which were there before this January 2020 are anymore existing. So if I talk from this drone point of view, or if I have said this autonomous robot vehicles where there is no drivers or driverless machines are running on roads, and they are providing medical supplies and food supplies. So this has been another innovation that took place with the help of IT in supply chain. Third has been the AR/VR, you know, the virtual reality. Now, again, I related to the contactless. People wanted less of human intervention. So what they wanted was that they want to take a look of whether it is in a factory or it is in some residential plot, you know, or some residential projects, maybe commercial projects also. So whether it is the real estate business or it is some manufacturing setup, they do not require a person to help in seeing the location or finding out. If I, for that matter, if I take an example of a factory, then the owner do not have to ask the supervisor to share the current status. In fact, they can access the real-time data with the help of these tools, which are accompanied by these AR/VR technology. That means with a virtual scenario, you can keep a tab on your employees, that whether they are working in the due hours, when it is something on consumer or the, in fact, the customer visiting to a place, want to see the entire location. So you don't have to ask the customer, especially with reference to real estate, to visit physically to that place. Instead of that, they can go through that virtual reality tour, and every place, every nook and corner, they can find out that where is, let's say, the balcony area, where is the room area, where is the kitchen area. So whatever they wish to, so they can have a very, very close mapping of the entire plot area, which they wish to discover, which they wish to invest into. Then another one is in the inventory. With the help of, if I say, whether it is in 3D printing form or with the help of, you can say, contactless. So there has been companies, not in India, but outside India, there has been companies who have come out with an option where maybe if you enter as a shopper and you pick up things and put them into your physical cart, right? So by default, there'll be a virtual cart that will be created through that particular store. And whatever items you'll keep on picking up from that particular store, they will be entered into your virtual cart. To make it easy to understand, like we do in e-commerce, through e-commerce platforms. So whatever you pick here being at the store, similarly, they are being entered in a virtual cart also. And whatever stock you can, there could be two ways, that you download their apps and you move out of the store, you do not talk to anybody in the store and make the payment via your device where you have installed the app. And nobody would stop you, because once the payment has been received, the items are being checked. So you can make. Otherwise, even if you go to the counter, you do not, neither you nor the employee will be shifting the products from your physical cart to the any bags or something. You, with the help of that virtual cart, they will be doing the entire billing, and you will be making again payment through a contactless mode, and finally you can take the things with you. If we see the other side, then that means the inventory optimization or the inventory real-time data bin. So whenever any customer is doing this thing, your supply chain, which is directly connected with the inventory management, there the real-time information, once the shopper shops, reaches to the warehouse where that inventory stock has been updated, and that's the same information that has been communicated to the suppliers in a real-time form. So no more the supply chains are working on the form of efficient supply chain. In fact, they have moved on to responsive supply chain. In a case of responsive supply chain, in fact, resilient supply chain is also quite a common term used these days. So what have the organization opt for their model is, they have become more agile, they have become more flexible in adopting the technologies which gives convenience to the consumer. It is not only with respect to any only manufacturing, it has entered into the supply chain services or the services sector also, into the e-commerce sector also, into the retail sector also. hospitality, come what may, wherever you name. I'll again share one example of how it works in the hotel industry also. If I wish to keep a track of the inventory of hotels, so again there, because that is part of again my supply chain, that I want to have an inventory optimization for. So for a hotel, the inventory is their rooms. So in that case, they do not offer the key to the their customers in a hard form. In fact, they have created digital keys through which the customer can again have a look, first of all, of their rooms before they enter into the room. There'll be no employee who will be will be there accompanying them. Everything will be taken care of by the customer on their own. So they can open the room with the help of the digital key. They can use all the amenities which are given in the hotel without any intervention of any employee. They do not, if I talk about the old way, you have to go to the reception, you'll be asking for the key, then there'll be a person who will be taking all your things to the room, then they'll open the room, then you'll enter. Now, can you see that how this IT development has changed the scenario from the perspective of if you see its intervention in the manufacturing sector, or that for that matter in the service sector, in hospitality sector. So if we see from a larger perspective, there have been a lot many IoT. IoT and AI are the most latest ways or developments. So actually in Internet of Things, this is the last tool I want to talk about. So in that, generally we say that you create a digital twin. That means for everything which has a physical existence, you create a digital replica of the same thing. And with the help of that digital replica, you do not have to use the physical component. Say for example, if in a manufacturing setup, I have to start a machine. So if I think from the traditional point of view, there should be a person who should switch on the power, then plug in and go for its starting up, and then finally the machine is in a mode of starting the production. But gone are those days. Now you have a simulated model with the help of a software on your computer, on your laptop, and with a single instruction you are able to operate your machine from your remote location, and you can run that machine at a distant location. So these kind of, you can say, extra enormous developments have taken place. If you have to speak on this topic, you can speak for hours. But I thought I picked up, that's the only reason I picked only five major developments. So if I talk from the perspective of companies, like I gave you the example of all the automobile companies who were using, or the aircraft companies who utilized their skill in making ventilators with the help of 3D printing. Similarly, company, like I said, Asian Paints, they have a typical component as ethyl alcohol, which has been used. So instead of producing the paints, because that time there was no market, people, you could not go to the your customer's house, or you could not create your client base. So instead of that, they found that the most necessary item which should be available for hygiene, for safety, is ethyl alcohol. So Asian Paints started sending there in the market via their supply chain. So they become suppliers of ethyl alcohol in the form of, which in common terms we call them as sanitizers. So they entered into this market just to utilize their resources, right? So if you have any queries, the forum is open to all of you. I think justice to the topic being given to me.
Anyone, any questions? Mansi? Naina, Sarvi, any questions you have? I don't think they have any questions. Raja Rajeshwari?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any questions?
No, sir.
Come on. Okay. You can proceed with the.
Okay, sir. We would like to propose a hearty vote of thanks to you, Dr. Sunaina Jain, for gracing today's webinar and delivering the important topic on IT development in supply chain during COVID-19 era. I'm sure that all the participants have taken note of your suggestion and will integrate that further in their career. Lastly, we thank you again on the behalf of whole Agro Aviation Private Limited team. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for the wonderful webinar.
Thank you. Thank you so much.